Okay, today we are going to discuss the problem on how to write a bending moment diagram for portal frame without sway. So this was the frame I have considered here, the structure as a frame. These are supports, A and D are the supports, fixed supports, B and D are the joints. So the height of the frame here is 3 meter at both ends, that is AB and CD are having same height, 3 meter. So whereas BC is having a length of 4 meter. So it is acted upon by a point load 80 kN exactly at the center of the BC, that is 2 meter from the left points B and 2 meter from C point. So if you go for geometric properties, the it is I. So in all the three elements, moment of inertia. So I have calculated the end moments using slope reflection method. So end moments are like this. So the final end moments. The MEB value is plus 14.56 kN meter, nothing plus is nothing but clockwise according to my sign convention. So MBA is plus 14.56, MEB. MBA is plus 29.13 kN meter clockwise, MBC minus 29.13 kN meter anticlockwise, MCB plus 29.13 kN meter clockwise, MCD minus 29.13 nothing but anticlockwise, MDC is minus anticlockwise. So you can skip the sign while writing. You can write the the nature of the moment here. Otherwise, you can write the sign convention here. So minus, according to my sign convention, negative means anticlockwise, positive means clockwise. And I have calculated the free bending moment value also. This only the beam element is acted upon by external load. For this load, the free bending moment value is, since it is point load acting exactly at the center, the bending moment value is WL by 4, that is 80 into 4 by 4 equal to 80 kN meter. Now the question is how we need to write complete BMD for this frame without sway. So first what we need to write here is, first we should write the final end moment diagram. So the final end moment diagram we should write here. So whatever the sign convention you have assumed while calculating the end moments, just during the process of slope reflection method or any method, after writing the end diagram, you should get the same diagram for any sign convention. So now we're going to start with the final end moment diagram. So again, we should write the portal frame. Again, we should write the frame like this. So without any loads. So this is what A point, this is what D point, B joint, C joint. Now we should write inverted arcs at all the supports like this. So please observe carefully here. So we should write inverted arc shape for all the three elements. So this is towards D, it should be inverted arc shape. So toward B, if you see this should be inverted to B. If you are here, if you see this inverted shape, this curved shape, this should be inverted to B. Likewise for C point and also for D point. So now please look at the value of MAB now. So MAB is 14.56 kN clockwise. So please stand here. Now where we are now? Now we are marking MAB. To mark MAB, we should stand at A point. So A point is here. So see the nature of the moment. So nature of the moment is clockwise. So here, to get clockwise moment in this arc, where we need to mark the arrow mark. So if you mark arrow mark on this side, left hand side, so it will cause anticlockwise moment A point. Therefore, what we should mark here is on the right hand side. So about this point, this will cause clockwise moment, since it is causing MAB is clockwise. Likewise, next go to B point. So look at A. So towards A, the moment is 29.13 clockwise. If you stay here and look at this, the arc, if you mark here inside, what will happen? About this point, this will cause anticlockwise moment. Therefore, if you mark arrow mark on this side, this will cause clockwise moment. So this similarly for BC, so standing at B point, BC value is anticlockwise of minus 29. So now if you mark, where we should mark the arrow mark? So about B point, if you mark arrow mark on this side of the arc, this inverted arc, so about this point, you are going to get anticlockwise moment. So likewise, you go to C point now. So where is C point? So at C point, we have two members connecting. CB member is clockwise moment is causing here. So about this point, we should mark outside the arrow mark to get clockwise moment due to this arc about C point. Now again, standard C point. So you see the nature of CD span, the moment, anticlockwise moment. So where I should mark this? If you mark outside here, this will give our anticlockwise moment. If you mark inside about this arc, so on this side, this will cause clockwise moment. Therefore, so we should mark outside. Similarly, for D point, go D point, see the nature of the moment, that is anticlockwise, we should write inside. So on the left hand side of your side to get anticlockwise effect. This was final end moment diagram. So what is the value here? So I will not need to write the sign again. So 40 kilonewton per meter, 14.56 here. So since it is symmetric same, you are getting the same answer. So 29.13 kilonewton. So all the units are in kilonewton meter. So we should be observed carefully here that. So at joints. So at joint, you should get, you know, both the arrow mark in, you know, outside the frame or inside the frame. So you should verify this one. If it is one is inside, one is outside. So I think you did some wrong, you know, marking. So please be careful here. So the arrow mark should be should be outside, both are inside. So it's here, both are outside. So we have marked it correctly now. So the thing is here, finally, while writing final moment diagram, go to the point and mark the arrow mark to get the so moment nature, what we calculated in the final end moment. So now we'll move on to how to write BMD for this. So I'll write again the frame here. I'm going to write the frame now. Okay. So now this is the, you know, support A and D point. So A and D. So now I should mark the value of 14.56 here. If you mark 14.56 here, so please, sorry, this is the simplest method I am telling. So if you see the arrow mark, this is your right hand side of your column element, that is AB element, or inside the frame. So while marking the, you know, the ordinate of 14.56, I should mark inside. Why? Because the arrowhead is inside the frame. So this is what my value, 14.56 kilonewton meter. Next, you go to B point. So this is what arrowhead is outside the frame. So that means I should write, so to my left hand side, not in the inside the frame. So how much the value? 29.13. So double than this, the 14.56. So mark some ordinate that is 29.13. Why I written outside here is the arrowhead is outside the frame, on the left hand side of the frame. Then join these two using inclined line. These two ordinates. This is our bending moment diagram for this column element, that is AB element. Now we'll move on to BC element first. This is what BC element, our BC element. So here arrowhead is above the beam. So therefore I should mark the ordinate above the beam, not inside. So how much the value? If you see the value, what is that? BC value. What is BC value? Minus 29. So not minus 29, the magnitude is 29. How I should mark here? So I should mark, you know, ordinate equal to this. 29.13. Why I should written outside here? The arrowhead is outside. Then if you see CB here, arrowhead is again outside. So towards arrowhead side, we are marking the ordinates. In simpler way, what we can say, towards the arrowhead side, we are marking the ordinates, 29.13. So then join these two. So this is what your BMD, support end moment diagram for CB element. If you go for CD element, if you see arrow mark is outside, therefore I need to mark outside. This is 29.13. So again, the arrow mark is inside here at support D point. We should mark inside. How much? So we should write to some scale. So 15.56. Now we need to join these two. So these two ordinates we should join. This is what the bending moment diagram for CD span. So after this, I will go on to read free end moment diagram for span BC. Only span BC is acted upon by load. So we already calculated the value 80 kilonewton meter. So for point load, we know the shape of the bending moment diagram. The shape will be like this. That is triangular shape. Okay. This is what the value is, 80 kilonewton meter. This is what free bending moment diagram. So now, now the question is how we should mark plus and minus here. Okay. So for that, So for this, since it is the first problem, go inside the frame. Please look at this frame. Please turn this one. Turn the page. If you turn, so you see the nature of AB moment. Nature is pushing down the frame. Pushing down the element AB. Therefore, pushing down means it will going to cause sagging moment. That means due to this moment, the beam will going to bend like this. Sagging effect will be there, pushing inside the frame. Therefore, here we should mark plus. If you see this arrow head, this frame, okay, if you see from this side, that is from your left hand side, when you went to the inside the frame, so it is acting outside the frame, okay, it is, you know, causing, pulling, you know, pushing up the plane, up the beam, that is, it will bend like this here, so that will cause hagging moment, that will become negative. So again, for BC element, if you see the nature of the moment acting at BC, so this is what pushing up the beam, that is BC element, therefore this will be negative and this is also up the beam negative. If you want to write what nature for a CD span, please turn here, please look at this. So if you look at here, your bending moment diagram, final end moment, this arrowhead, this arrow is pushing up the beam, pushing up the beam, hugging, it's causing hugging moment, therefore hugging is negative. So this is pushing down the beam, so due to application of this moment, the beam will going to bend like this, okay, then therefore this will be positive. So here again for the free end moment diagram, that is for free end moment, so we know that that is positive moment. So therefore if this is the bending moment area, what we should mark here, so with nature plus and minus, so here, so this portion is cancelled each other, so plus and minus is cancelled each other. So the thing is, while writing this plus and minus, you should go inside the frame and look at each element as a beam element. So if the arrowhead is causing pushing down, then you should mark towards that plus. It is pushing up, then you should mark minus, that is hugging. So this is simplest method to mark SFT and BMD. So thank you for